Hi, I'm Shelley Stonebrook, the gardening editor at Mother Earth News, reporting live from the pond behind our publishing company's office. Today we're talking about seed starting. We had a reader write to us and ask about wanting to start her own vegetable seedlings, and she's wondering if she'll need special lights to do so. So the answer is yes. Special lights will definitely help you with your success in seed starting. The reason why you don't necessarily want to just put your little seed pots next to a sunny window is that the light coming through that window is probably not going to be quite strong enough to really get your seeds off to a good start. They'll germinate, but what will happen if seeds don't have quite strong enough light is that they'll be a little bit spindly, and you want your seeds to have plenty of bright light so that the little seeds as they grow will have really strong stems on them. So one of the things that you want to look for in getting your seed starting setup ready is a specific kind of light. So often for grow lights, people use what's called T12 shop lights. These are widely available in home improvement stores and things like that. But they're relatively inexpensive, but there are a couple better options on the market. Two better and more efficient types of bulbs are the T5 and the T8 bulbs. And the T stands for tube, and the number right after that stands for the diameter of the bulb. So that should be clearly marked on the packages as you're shopping. And then you can also just look at that diameter of a 5 versus the 8. Usually these bulbs will be about 4 feet long, and the fixtures to attach the bulbs, those are about $20. You should also be able to find those at the similar stores. And then the bulbs are about $10. So you should be able to get a pretty efficient seed starting setup for $30 total. So another really important key as you're getting set up with your new lights and your new fixture is to make sure to get your seed starting pots up really close to the lights. The reason for this is that just like with sunshine, having the pots too far away from the lights just means that the strength of the light isn't as high as it could be. So if you get them right up close to the lights, it'll prevent you from having spindly or weak seedlings. One last tip is that you want to be sure to keep your lights on your seedlings for quite a few hours a day. You can even do it up to 18 hours a day and then just shut off the lights at night. If you want to spring a little bit of extra money into this project, you can get an automatic timer for your setup. So you can just set it to turn on at a certain point in the morning and then turn off at night. So that way you know that your seedlings are getting the right amount of light all day long as they're growing. For more information on seed starting and getting your light fixture set up, just search for seed starting at motherearthnews.com. Happy gardening!